गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी, आई एम एन मल्लेश, वर्किंग एज ए असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन सेंट मार्टिन्स इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज. नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू से अबाउट वन ग्रामर टॉपिक, दैट इज वर्ब. वी आर विद वर्ब. सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच. इफ यू सी एनी सेंटेंसेस, मीनिंगफुल सेंटेंस आर एनी सेंटेंसेस, इफ यू सी verb should be there. Without verb, there is no sentence. We cannot speak any word or any sentences. So that's why what is verb, we should know. The definition of verb is, so it expresses an action, state of being and position. It expresses an action. Action, state of being and also position. Position. Yeah, action means here, you see, go, went, gone, going. So this verb form, sir, go is expressing action, and here I am a lecturer, that am is not expressing action. So here go, went, gone and going. Go, went, gone, going, v1, v2, v3 and v4, these four are verb forms, sir. So we can know that these are expressing actions. So action telling words are called verbs. And also here go, went, gone, going and eat, ate, eaten and eating. Ask, asked, asking. So here there is some action. So action telling words are called verb. Also we know three definition for verb. State of being. So here am, is, are, was and were. And be form also too. These will express the state of one person. Okay, I am here, I am a lecturer, you are students. R is saying about your state of being. So that am is the verbs will say about state of being, not only action, state of being, what you are, whether you are teacher, a student or a scientist, what doctor, it says. Next here, position means belonging, possessing, having. So here have, has, had, these verbs are called possessing verbs, or these also one type of verbs. Here have, has, had. So finally what we have to know here, action telling verbs are verbs and state of being telling words are verbs and possession telling words are verbs. Okay, classification, we need to know classification in verbs. Verbs are two types of auxiliary verbs and lexical verbs means main verb. We also can say this as a mixed main verbs. Auxiliary verbs are many kinds, like see, auxiliary means here it helps to main verb. It looks very small, am, is, are, very small, it helps to main verb. Okay, see here, what are the types in auxiliary we should know? Here, primary auxiliary verbs, and also we know modal auxiliary verbs. What are primary auxiliary verbs? We should know now. Here, B forms, like just now I wrote there, for definition purpose I have written upside. Once again, in classification I am writing here, B forms, here, B form box, we can know that box. In B form, am, is, are, was, were, more than, like B. B is in B only, no need to write again. Am, is, are, was, were called B forms. Next here, it says about state of being. I have said just now, this will say about the state of being of a particular person. They are students, they are doctors. Okay, she was a nice person in the childhood. It indicates that it is now is a not nice person. Okay, na? It is saying the state of being of a particular person, whether it is a past tense or present tense. Here, present state of being. Am is are indicating present state of being. I am a teacher. She is a doctor. They are friends. They are friends means they were friends means here. Now they are not friends. They became enemies. They have some clashes. Okay. They were friends means here. that condition, that state of being, it is indicated that they were best friends, now they are not friends. Okay, present to state of being and past to state of being. He was a liar, means now he is not a liar. He might be retired or also he resigned to the job. He was liar, means here no more. We can know that no more. Okay, here see, amateur, was, were, are the state of being, be forms, it indicates state of being. In primary advisory, this is one kind. Next, do forms. Do forms are do, does, and did. Do, does, and did. Here, it will work as both like you see, auxiliary verb and also main verb. It has four forms like do, does, did, and done. Okay, do, does is a past V1, the do, does, and did is a V2, done is V3, doing is fourth verb. Okay, na? This one is using as a auxiliary and a main verb too. Okay, in some competitive exams, they will ask this which verb is used both as an auxiliary and also main verb. That is do form. So, in questioning time, yes or no questioning time, we will use these verbs. Do you come to college regularly next year? Does it apply? Questioning for yes or no questions. Not only here also we can know. We can ask yes or no questions. Okay. Do, does, and did. These are do forms. And also we should know have forms. Have forms, so means here have, has, and had. These are possessing verbs. See here, they have large building. They have large building means here present possession. This indicates it refers present to indicate present to belonging, present to possession. For example, she has humanity. She has humanity means presently she has humanity. She can help to anybody. But yes, she had humanity means she changed. She changed due to that thing or whatever conditions. She had humanity means now she is not helping to anybody. So present to possession, past to possession. He had 1 crore amount. He had 1 crore amount, but now he is not having. Okay. Here, present having, past having. So have can be used for plural. Plural. I, we, you, they. After we will see have. For he, she, it, and any singular except I, we will see here as. Okay. Next, had means for both. For plural and singular, we will use I had, we had, they had, you had, she had, because. Here for pastness and present, there is difference in have has, but in had there is no we have to show commonly for all subjects. Okay, this is about have forms. Next here, this we use in tenses too. These be forms, so these have forms, so we will use in tenses four tenses to 12 sentences then. So by that help or combination of this only this will help in the structure of tenses. Okay. Next, modal auxiliary verbs are can, could, shall, should, may, might, used to, ought to. So these are called modal auxiliary verbs. Here this is also auxiliary verb. This is also auxiliary verb. We can see these words independently without helping or we can see without a main verb, but here we cannot see these words with a main verb. For example, I can come here. Come is a main verb, lexical verb is there. So independently we cannot see this. It takes the help of a main verb. Okay, na? I can reach. So this modal verb. Immediately we will see, after that we will see one lexical verb. So this will say that can ability, can and could, present ability, past ability, and also shall, should, it says about future and also obligation means compulsory duty, like meaning it will give here ability, obligation, and also some permissions like permissions. Okay, past action, they used to do dance, now they are not doing dance like that, it will say. So modal auxiliaries, these are all called modal auxiliaries. Auxiliary verbs, primary auxiliary, V forms, do forms, have forms, in the same axillary only another type model axillaries can coat shell should so on etc. Next we should go to another part and verb that is very important lexical verbs means main verbs. So here we will see regular verbs and regular verbs and irregular verbs. So main verbs means the verb which has four forms like go, went, gone, going, eat, ate, eaten and eating. Next speak, spoke, spoken and speaking. So here we should know about a regular verb. What is regular verb also we should know. So for example, first we should know verb forms. Like here regular verbs means here ask, asked, asked and asking. See here this is v1, v2, v3 and v4. Next here move, moved and moved and moving. So here ending verb 2 and verb 3 endings are ed, same. So this is called regular verb. Say verb 2 and verb 3 are with ed, or in other words like come we'll see in the same words. So v2 and v3 are same, but in some example like v1 and v3 come are also same. Here ed endings are called regular verbs, whereas irregular verb means so 4 will be different, like eat, ate, eaten and last one eating, completely different. Okay na? For avoiding see eat, ate, eaten. Next here go, went, gone. Go, went, gone, so completely different. These are called irregular verbs, regular verbs and irregular verbs. Okay, where we learn about this topic regular and irregular means it is very useful in a very essential in a passive voice time. The structure of passive voice is B plus V3, subject plus B plus Y plus object. This time for V3, for V2, V3 same, this one we can use. But here irregular verbs we have to use compulsory this verb 3 form only. But here in regular verbs, this one easy only. For V2 also we can write here because V2 and V3 are same. Okay, now these are example for regular and irregular. We also should know about another type in our verbs. Where the topic is about verbs, that's why I want to say other types of verbs too. Here transitive verbs are there. Transitive verb means here a verb which has object that is called transitive verb. For example, see here I wrote a letter. Here wrote is verb, letter is object. Wrote is a verb. Letter is an object, so it has object. This is called transitive verb. Whereas intransitive verb means here, see intransitive. For example, birds fly in the sky. So here the word of fly, it won't have object. In the sky is not object. So yeah, one clue is there for identifying intransitive verbs. Transitive or intransitive. In a sentence, if you see preposition after verb, it is not a transitive verb, it is a intransitive verb. Birds fly in the sky. We are sitting in the classroom. Sitting in the classroom. No, sitting is not having object. That's why it is not a transitive verb, it is a intransitive verb. Also, we should know about what is finite verb and a non-finite verb. Finite verb means here. I eat a mango. Here the eat is a finite verb because it is associated with the subject, it is associated with the tense, it is associated with the subject, object, gender, number, or it is associated with all the all gender and tense. But here the non-finite verb, like I written a letter, it is not a proper sentence. This written is not giving meaning. So it has to take the help of any have form and helping verb, then it will give meaning. So this is in intransitive verb. Sorry, it is in non-finite verb. In irregular verbs, eat, ate, eaten, and eating. Verb 3 and verb 4 are example for non-finite verbs. But here verb 3 and verb 4 are example for non-finite verbs. So, for example, I wrote here, I written a letter. This, they are speaking is right. They speaking is wrong because speaking is a non-finite verb. To infinity is also example for non-finite. She came here to write a book. She came here to write a book. To write is a non-finite verb. That's why it won't associated with the tense, gender and number. So these are the types, you know, verbs. I told just now, I have told you about verb, what's the definition here, and also types, auxiliary and modal. In auxiliary, two types, primary auxiliary, modal auxiliary. Here V forms, do forms and have forms. Here amuser, was, were are B types. Do forms are do, does, did. Have forms are have, has, had. Next here, modal auxiliary is another auxiliary. Here can, could, shall, should, may, might, used to. These are example for modal auxiliary. Next, second one is lexical verb and main verb. Here lexical verb and main verb, which has four forms like go, went, gone, going, are called lexical verb or main verb. We should know about the type, another type, regular verb and irregular verb. This is also example for lexical verb. Ask, asked, asked and asking. V2 and V3 endings are EDs. Any two same means here regular. Here irregular means four different, that is called irregular verbs. So these are example regular and irregular definition. Next one, I have also told about transitive and intransitive. Here transitive means the verb which has some object. Here I wrote a letter, the verb wrote has an objective. So this is a transitive verb. Intransitive verb means here the verb which doesn't have objective, like your birds fly in the sky. Fly is a verb which doesn't contain objective. In the sky is a not objective. Thank you.